Oh, hi there. I'm Bart. Can I borrow your attention for a second? Because I'm going to show you an awesome beetle. Wait, that's the wrong drawer. Give me one second. Ah, there you go. Here we have the European stag beetle, Lucanus carvus. Thanks for watching. What do you think of when I say the word stag beetle? Despite the stag beetles actually being a family of beetles that contains over 1200 species, there is a fair chance that a particular species came to mind. Lucanus carvus, the stag beetle, perhaps one of the most famous representatives of this group. It is perhaps the best known species of stag beetle in the world. It is a very widespread beetle throughout Europe and is found almost everywhere, although it does seem to be absent from Ireland, the south of Spain and most of Scandinavia, with the exception of southern Sweden. It is found in almost the entire mainland of Europe, however. Besides that, it is also found in Eastern Europe and the Balkans, Turkey, Syria, Kazakhstan and the western part of Russia. It does seem to be absent in most of Asia. It is one of the largest species of beetle that one can find in Europe. The males of this species are the most conspicuous, for they have enlarged mandibles that almost resemble the horns of a stag, hence the common name of this species, aka stag beetle. So why do they have these anyways? It's all about competition. The males of Lucanus carvus, well, they fight a lot. Usually the males will guard the females from rivals. Males are said to keep territories as well. In the world of stag beetles, only the strongest and biggest males are allowed to pair with the female. Males fight each other with their strong mandibles, and the outcome of a male-to-male contest depends strongly on the body size difference between the two rivals. If the aggressor is the largest of the two males, he has a high chance of winning the contest. And if the outcome of the contest, if the aggressor is the smallest of the two males, he is likely to lose. The environment favors the biggest and strongest males. The female, however, compared to the males, is quite small. She doesn't have enlarged mandibles and has a smaller body size. She also lives a more hidden lifestyle. While the males of this species are very active and can wander a lot, females try to avoid detection. The sexual dimorphism in this species is quite striking. The stag beetle, Lucanus carvus, has a complicated life cycle. Larvae feed on strongly decayed wood. Wood is extremely tough and hard to digest, which is why the larvae eat wood that is already breaking down and decomposing. Wood consists of cellulose and lignin, and in this case the lignin is an organic polymer that binds the cell walls together and makes them stronger, like wood. However, lignin easily rots, which is why fungi are able to break down the wood. And this type of rot, called white rot, softens the wood and allows the larva to eat it by destroying the lignin. Their diet mainly consists of cellulose, but cellulose is also hard to digest. This kind of diet is possible because of their symbiosis with cellulose decomposing bacteria that are held in an organ at the back of the gut. So in the end, it requires the aid of fungi and bacteria to break the wood down into something useful for the beetle. Still, the larvae have to consume a lot of wood to grow to the huge sizes that they are and face several harsh winters. It can take the larva 3 to 6 years to turn into an adult beetle. The life cycle is rather long for an insect. Their favorite kind of wood is oak tree, and they are highly dependent on the presence of oak in their environment. Despite that, less commonly, they have also been found to use other types of wood, such as ash tree, black poplar, beech, willow, horse chestnut, wild cherries, walnut, and more. Adults appear during late May to the beginning of August, being most active in the evenings. Females lay their eggs in a piece of decaying wood deep in the soil. It's funny that the larvae spend 3 to 6 years of their life feeding on rotten wood to turn into an adult beetle. But the adult beetles only live for a few weeks. This is because the beetles can barely eat. They only live to find a partner, lay eggs, and die. The mouth parts of the adult beetles are very soft and resemble two feather-like brushes. With these brushes, they can swipe and suck up moisture. Their diet consists of sweet juices such as fruit juice from fallen fruits, but also tree sap from bleeding trees, and any type of sweet liquid that's available, really. However, because of the way their mouth is formed, it is not possible for the beetles to chew or take food in solid form because they don't have jaws. This severely limits their lifespan because they can only drink food in liquid form. It's like trying to live off energy drinks. And even in optimal conditions, fruit juices aren't going to sustain them for very long. So eventually, the adults of these beetles starve and die because they run out of energy. Although eating may prolong their lifespan by a few days' time. The stag beetle, Lucanus carvus, although absent in some countries, is distributed widely across Europe. However, from the conservation point of view, it is of concern that in many of the countries where it is present, it has an endangered or protected status and has been included in the Annex 2 of the EC Habitats Directive and is classed as an European protected species and has an International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, status of near threatened from 2010 across Europe. Legislation is giving the species a protected status and has been enacted throughout the European Union. Despite that, the species had been declining lately. The main threat to this species is deforestation, since these big and slow-growing beetles develop in the rotting wood of trees. Another interesting threat to this species is improper forest management. In the past, forests were often mismanaged in Europe, especially when it comes to dealing with trees. It was not uncommon for forest management to remove sick, dying or dead trees from the forest itself. It was a threat to the beetle, because their survival depends on the availability of dead trees. Luckily, today we realize how important it is to leave dead things in the forest, where they should decompose naturally, and more efforts are being made to leave piles of rotting wood in the forest to benefit the ecosystem. The good news is that the stag beetle, Lucanus carvus, is still very widespread in Europe today, and not by any means threatened by extinction. And some big and healthy populations still exist. However, its decline is still a reason for concerns. And while this species is doing relatively well on a big continental scale, in some countries in Europe, it has been driven extinct by deforestation and mismanagement of the forests. And the species should be monitored to prevent this from happening on a big scale. We would hate to lose this beautiful and charismatic important beetle species in Europe. Thank you all for watching. This video contains some copyrighted materials that I'm allowed to use under the fair use law, since their use is transformatory and non-commercial in nature. Please note that my entire YouTube channel is demonetized and that I do not make any revenue from my videos. Consider supporting me financially on Patreon. This channel runs on donations for 100%. Even a few dollars helps me a lot collectively and allows me to improve the materials and equipment that I use for filming and educating people about nature and environment. I hope to see you again next episode. Hello everyone, and thank you for watching this week's episode of Drawer of the Week. My name is Bart Koppens and I work with butterflies and moths, both dead ones and live ones, because I breed them in captivity. I study them, I film them, I photograph them, I research them, and I volunteer in a museum collection where I'm a conservator of the butterflies and moths. Now, Drawer of the Week is my weekly series where I show you one drawer with interesting specimens from a museum and give you some interesting facts about them. If you like it, like my video, subscribe to my channel, and consider joining my crowdfunding platform, Patreon. Because only with your help, my mission to educate the whole world about insects can be fulfilled. Thanks for watching, and hopefully see you next episode of this weekly series. Hello everyone, and thank you for watching my Drawer of the Week mini-series. I would like to take a moment to say thanks to the Natural History Museum of Rotterdam, or in Dutch, Het Natuurhistorisch Museum van Rotterdam. All the insect videos I film in the scientific collection of the Rotterdam Natural History Museum, where I work as a honorary junior conservator. Thanks for watching, and till next time.